Irish women. In the name of God and of the next generation from which it receives our own tradition of nationhood, Ireland, to us, sons and children, to our flag and stripes for our freedom. Having organized and trained her manhood to a sacred revolutionary organization, the Irish Republic of Brotherhood, and to our open military organizations, the Irish Volunteers and the Irish Citizen Army, having patiently perfected her discipline, having resolutely waited for the right moment to reveal itself, she now seizes that moment, and with the support of our exiled children in America, and by gallant allies in Europe, but at first, depending on our own strength, we strike in full confidence of victory. religious and civil liberties, equal rights and equal opportunities to all its citizens. And oblivious of the differences carefully fostered by an alien government which have divided the minority from the majority in the past. Until our arms have brought about an opportune moment for the establishment of a permanent national government representative of the whole people of Ireland and by the suffrages of all her men and women. The provisional government, hereby constituted, will administer the civil and ministry affairs of the nation in trust for our people. We place the cause of the Irish Republic under the protection of the Most High God and pray that nobody who serves that cause will dishonor it by cowardice, inhumane or deplorable man. In this supreme hour, the Irish people, by its valor and by its discipline and by the readiness of its children to sacrifice themselves for the common good, prove itself worthy of the august destiny for which we are called. Thank you.